shall reflect on the life of Saint Gregory Nazianzen. Like Saint Basil, Saint Gregory was also born into a family of saints. The young Gregory first studied at Caesarea in Cappadocia and there formed an intimate friendship with Saint Basil. Later, studies took him to Caesarea in Palestine, to Alexandria in Egypt, and finally to Athens, where he rejoined Basil in studying rhetoric for some 10 years and had as a fellow student a certain Julian who was to go down in history as the apostate. Gregory was 31 when, on returning home, both he and Basil decided to devote their lives entirely to God's service as hermits. But after a few years, Gregory's father insisted on ordaining his gifted but hesitant son to the priesthood. 11 years later, his friend, Saint Basil the Great, who had meanwhile become his metropolitan, consecrated him bishop against his will. But Gregory, considering it to have been a semi-political move, left his diocese soon after and returned to Nazianzus to assist his aged father. The city of Constantinople had for some 30 years been the stronghold of the Arian heresy, but in 379 a reluctant Gregory was called there by a small remnant of faithful Catholics. By his great sanctity, learning and eloquence, he brought about a genuine rebirth of the true faith. His 5 remarkable theological discourses on the Holy Trinity in the light of the Nicene Creed earned him the title the Divine. In 380, Theodosius, having become emperor, had the Arian patriarch exiled and replaced with Gregory, an act the Second Ecumenical Council approved the following year. However, Saint Gregory's gentle, retiring, and highly sensitive nature, coupled with his continually poor health, caused him to resign from this new but stormy posting after only a few months, and he finally retired to Nazianzus, where he died.